So one day I was at my computer and I was kind of got lost on YouTube as I do sometimes, and I came across this guy. He was giving a talk, and within like 2 minutes of me listening to this guy, I was just fired up. The intensity, the emotion, and the way he delivered this speech was just absolutely incredible. I haven't seen this in many speakers before. I was like, who the hell is this guy? His name is Eric Thomas, and today's book is his story of coming from like complete and utter adversity to turning his life around and being an incredibly successful guy.
He said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.
So this book is mainly an autobiography, but it's infused with tips and tricks on how to be successful, or little things that he's picked up along the way. So it's pretty interesting read. Let me give you a brief overview of his story. So he was born in Detroit in the 1970s, and Detroit was booming back then, not like it is today. And he had a relatively good upbringing until about the age of 12. He had a really good relationship with his mother. With his father, it wasn't so good. His father used to beat him. But then one day he also found out at the age of 12 that his dad wasn't actually his real dad. I mean, that's just terrible, right? You have a kid who's been beaten by his dad, and then at 12 years old, he finds out that that's not his real dad. So that kind of pushed him over the edge. You know, he started hanging out with the wrong crowd, dropped out of school, and then one day, it all came to a head. They had a huge argument with his parents at home, and he went to walk out that door, and they said, listen, if you walk out that door, you ain't ever coming back. You know, his pride was too great, he'd had enough. Out the door he went, and he was homeless in Detroit. Obviously, homeless in Detroit is a pretty nasty place to be. And the way he described it, he was scared, he was hungry, you know, he was cold, and it was like rock bottom for him. But adversity can kind of send you one of two ways. It can kind of be all too much for you, you just cave in, you give up to everything, or you can use it as that pain, you can use that pain as fuel to get yourself out of that situation. And he took responsibility. He said, you know, I'm responsible for getting myself into this situation, I'm gonna be responsible for getting myself out of this situation. That was the fighting spirit that eventually helped him. He took any job he could find, made as much money as he could. He took a room in his friend's house, and at school, he started getting his head down. He started studying hard. He wasn't the best student, but he dedicated himself to it. He started to realize that it's really important who you hang around with. And up until this point, he'd only have negative influences from people that he'd been hanging around with. But now, he started to look for positive influences, and he came across this group of black young men who are all really ambitious, trying to be successful. Some of them want to be lawyers, some of them want to be engineers, and they're all giving talks for free. They're practicing their public speaking skills. So he was like, you know what? These are the guys. I look up to these guys. These are my inspiration. Start hanging around with them. And then one day, one of the guys, supposed to give a speech to 400 people, didn't show up. And so Eric just jumped up to the plate. He's like, yeah, let me in. I want to do this. He gave his speech, really nervous, of course, but he got massive positive feedback. Everybody was like, man, you hit my heart with that speech that you gave. Up until this point in his life, he never really got any positive feedback from anybody apart from football. That was his love. He loved football, right? But now he had some positive feedback for something intellectual. And he's like, man, maybe there's something here. You know, maybe I can be a speaker. So he was like, you know what? I got a gift for public speaking. I think I'm gonna run with this. Let's see how far I can get. So he started up his public speaking company. And for the first year, it was tough. Really hard to pay the bills. He was almost at breaking point, and then suddenly broke through and everything started happening for him. He just kept at it. His videos started going viral. And now he's a worldwide famous public speaker with a multi-million-dollar business behind him. But you know what the funny thing is? Starting and building a multi-million dollar company wasn't the hardest thing he had to face. His two biggest challenges, by his own admission, number one was getting his degree. That took him 12 years, but mainly it took him overcoming his limiting belief that he wasn't smart enough and that he couldn't do it. And number two, it was finally finding the courage to forgive his father for everything that he'd done. All right, so what are the takeaways from this book? Well, if I'm completely honest, I didn't really get a whole lot in terms of practical tips out of this book. Yes, it's true, there are tips. There is kind of references to things that's happened in his life and how we can apply that to ours to be more successful. But really, the main purpose of this book for me is kind of like, it's like emotional rocket fuel. It's like when you're feeling bad about something, let's say you're trying to build a business, you're going through a bad phase, you can use something like this to prop yourself back up, because you'll read about all the shit that he went through, all the adversity that he went through and came out the other side, and you can kind of feel that emotion coming across, not only from his talks but also from this book, and that'll help pick you up and get you back on the straight and narrow. All in all, it's a great book. You get through it in like one afternoon, so it's well worth picking up. But for now, I'm gonna leave you with Eric Thomas.
Would a real Eric Thomas please stand up? Stop being this high school dropout. Stop giving up. Stop sleeping on the street. Stop walking up and down Finkel Avenue like you ain't got nothing, and get your GED. Stop being afraid to take a test. Stop being afraid to go to college because your daddy didn't go and your mama didn't go. Stop being afraid and be the best Eric Thomas you can be. But listen to me, it's gonna be hard. It took me 12 years to get a 4-year degree, but I got it. And guess what? On a degree, it don't have dates. So if it took you 4 and it took me 12, it don't show up nowhere. But I'm exactly where I wanted to be because I realized I gotta commit my very being to this thing. I gotta breathe it, I gotta eat it, I gotta sleep it. And until you get there, you'll never be successful in life. But once you get there, I guarantee you, the world is yours.